In this video, I want to share my 7 favorite automation tools that are going to help me to run my business in 2022. So let's just dive right in. Number 1, ActiveCampaign. So email marketing is a super duper important part of my business because most of my core sales are coming through email. So inside ActiveCampaign, I've built a whole system of automations that are automatically sending emails to people to get them engaged, to build trust by providing value, enough trust so that they might become a customer. And a little part of that system looks like this. So I, for example, have here an automation that is automatically delivering a download. For example, someone would request a cheat sheet, then the cheat sheet would be sent. And then what I think is so cool with ActiveCampaign is that you can then, based on their behavior with that first email, I could, for example, send a follow-up email if they did not open the first email. And then if they did engage with those emails, I could automatically start then an onboarding automation that is going to send a series of emails that is, for example, going to invite them for a free email course. And then if they take part in that free email course, also that free email course is automatically going to start and then automatically sends every lesson every single day. And I think that's super duper cool. So ActiveCampaign, definitely one of my favorite tools. Number 2, IntegraMod. And I would go as far as saying that this is the glue of the internet because you can use this to integrate all kinds of tools together without any programming knowledge. So here you see, for example, a little example where we are combining a Google Sheet with an email module, but you can use all kinds of cool things. So for example, what I did here, and it looks really techy, but it's actually really simple. So here I added a webhook to ActiveCampaign, and ActiveCampaign is going to send over some data to IntegraMod whenever there is a new lead or new contact. And then this is going to start. And then this module over here, which is called NeverBounce, is going to check if the email address I give it is a valid email address or if it's maybe a disposable or invalid email address. And then what I can do is I can create different paths based on that. And then I can, for example, say, okay, if the result of the NeverBounce module is disposable, then I want to unsubscribe this person from my list because it's not really a real person that wants to stay in touch with me, right? Or what I could also do is I could say, okay, I want this scenario to run every Thursday at 9 p.m. And then I wanted to check my YouTube RSS feed to see if there's any new videos. And if there's any new videos, I automatically want to post it to my Facebook page and to Twitter. And this was something I was first doing manually, and this is really saving me lots of time. Or maybe another fun thing to show is that over here I have a mail hook. So all my mail gets forwarded to IntegraMod. Then IntegraMod is going to check my Google Calendar to see if I'm currently on a holiday. And then if I'm on a holiday, then it's going to check here emails to see if I already emailed that person in the last 24 hours if I'm on a holiday. And if I did not send it out to reply to that person, then I will send an email to that person that says like, hey, just to let you know, I received your email, but I'm currently on a holiday. So I think IntegraMod is truly amazing. Really, you can do so many cool things with it. Number 3, Deadline Funnel. So I'm using Deadline Funnel to create authentic evergreen deadlines for my promotions. So I'm doing lots of promotions which are automated. So it would start based on when somebody is joining my email list or how they're engaging with certain emails. Then the promotion would start. But then what works really well is if you increase or give like a sense of urgency by adding a limit to that deadline, so that you would say, hey, this offer is valid for the next 3 days, for example. But you obviously do not want to lie to people, and that's why you would use a tool like Deadline Funnel, because you can then make a real deadline. And then what you can do is that after the deadline expired, that somebody cannot access that offer anymore. So it's like really an authentic evergreen deadline. And I think what is so cool with a tool like Deadline Funnel is that you can then also include like an email timer inside your email. So here I have an email that says something like, hey, you know, here's a little timer to show you how much time you have left. And then this is actually in sync with that unique deadline for that person. So here it would, for example, say like, hey, you still have 3 days, 8 hours, 56 minutes and 0 seconds. And then if they go over to that offer page, so that is this one over here, then you see that the same timer over here, we can also use on the web page. So then on this web page, we can again use this timer to make like a little sense of urgency. And you can even add some dynamic text with when the deadline is. So in this case, it would be on Sunday at 1:00 to midnight. And also down here, you can also add some dynamic text that says here, 3 days, 8 hours, 54 minutes and 23 seconds. So this is again in line or syncing with this timer over here and in this email. And then when the timer reaches zero, so the deadline is expired, then we can redirect people to a page like this. This is like, hey, sorry, offer expired. It seems like you're a bit late. If you want, you can still purchase this for the regular price. Purchase now. Pretty cool, right? Number four, write message. So I'm using write message for three different things. So I'm using it for opt-in forms on my website. I use it for surveys and quizzes to segment my audience. And I use it to personalize the website. So let me show you what that looks like. So for example, over here in this article at the bottom, I have an opt-in form. So you can see that over here. So here in this like pink red-ish block, you see this opt-in offer. So it's just asking for first name and an email address. And you would say like, yeah, but this is nothing new, right? Like this is not super exciting. But what is so cool is that you can automatically swap this call to action out by something else, depending on which page someone has visited, which products they purchased, etc., etc. So you could, for example, also say like, hey, if someone is already on my email list, I do not want to show a call to action at all. Or if someone is on my email list, instead of a call to action to join my email list, I want to show them an offer for one of my products. So something like this. And then when somebody is filling this out, then I redirect people to a welcome page that looks like this. So it says here, your template will be there in 5 minutes. Let's make it personal. In a few minutes, you'll receive the template. But before my automations get to work, I want to make sure I'm sending you exactly what you need. And then this part over here is also from Write Message. So it's like a little teeny tiny mini survey where people can click to let me know what describes them best. And what is truly amazing that each of these answers will be immediately synced to the email service provider. So in my case, that is ActiveCampaign. So if somebody would say here, I sell digital products, then boom, now in the profile of that person in ActiveCampaign, I can see that that person sells digital products. But what is even cooler and what I think is truly amazing is that you can also personalize content on your website based on the answers that people give you or what you already know about them. So for example, I have this text over here, right? So this is like my main blog overview page. And right here it says helpful articles and in-depth guides to help you become a better marketer. So this is just like the default text, but I can personalize this text based on what somebody is, for example, answering in this survey. So here I'm asking, what kind of digital products do you offer? If somebody would say here, online courses, if I now go back to this page, and if I refresh this page now, then you see that the headline changed. It says now, helpful articles and in-depth guides to help you sell more online courses. And this is obviously just a simple example, just swapping out the headline, but you can also swap out texts on your sales page. You can swap out testimonials. You can swap out videos or images, all kinds of things, depending on what you know about someone. So I truly, truly, truly love Write Message that allows you to do such cool things. Number five, Superforms, which is a really cool drag and drop form builder for WordPress that allows you to create dynamic forms, dynamic surveys, and add them to your website. So for example, something that I like to do in my free courses is that I add a little writing prompt at the bottom of a lesson to keep people engaged. And then people can fill this out. And then as soon as they click here, finish the writing prompt, then a PDF will be generated based on what they fill out and will be sent as a copy to that person. So that's pretty cool. And another thing that I really like to do is to do like a little entry survey at the beginning of my paid courses. So then in the first lesson, I would have a little video and then here a survey. And then I would, for example, ask like, hey, what is the main reason you purchased the course? Where did you first hear about me? What is your desired outcome? And I think where Superforms really shines is in dynamic questions based on other answers. So for example, here I'm asking people, what describes you best? If somebody would then say, I sell digital products, then you see, boom, another question appears right away. And that is asking, what kind of digital products do you sell? Now, then I could say here, for example, online courses. But if somebody would have clicked something different, for example, I sell physical products, then I ask a different question based on that. So this is just a super simple example, but I think dynamic questions based on other answers is a really cool feature. And previously I was using Typeforms for this, which I also really like, but they just have like a monthly subscription model and it was getting quite pricey. And I think with Superforms, you only have to pay $39 once. So it makes it a really clear recommendation. Number six, Calendly, which is a really easy scheduling platform that people can use to pick a spot inside my calendar without having to do any back and forth emailing of like, oh, are you available this day? Are you available that day? And just share a link with them and they can just pick a spot inside my calendar. So it works like this. You can create all kinds of different event types, really like that. And then it integrates with your Google Calendar or your Apple Calendar or whatever you're using. And then you can also set your availability inside Calendly. So I, for example, only like to do calls on Wednesdays and Thursdays, and then either at the beginning of the day or the end of the day. So super cool. So then when people are going to click this link, for example, here, this one, the example call, then the page looks like this. And then they can, for example, see, okay, hey, next Thursday, Max is available. Oh, he's available either at 9 a.m. or at 4 p.m. And then they can just click this, confirm, and they can fill out their data, and boom, that's that. And then number seven, WP Fusion, which you can use to connect your WordPress website to almost anything. I think there's tons of cool use cases for this, but how I'm personally using this is with my membership site. So whenever somebody is purchasing a course, then what I can do with WP Fusion, I can automatically create an account inside the membership site, which runs on WordPress, and send the login details to that person. So that's really cool. But then what I can also do is I can use WP Fusion to hook the website up with my email service provider. And in my email service provider, which is ActiveCampaign, I also store what someone purchased and to which courses they should have access. So what is really cool then is that inside the course settings, so in this case, in Taking Back Mastery, I can say, okay, I want to link this course with a tag inside ActiveCampaign that is called CP Access in Taking Back Mastery. And then what is really cool is that this course will be automatically unlocked for this person. So already the login details will be sent to them. They log in and they can right away access the course. And then, for example, if they would ask for a refund, which sometimes happens, right, then I can also automatically withdraw that access by removing that tag. So the next time they log in, they cannot access the course anymore. So I think it's super cool, but I'm really nervous scratching the surface here. I know that you can also personalize things on your website with it. You can integrate maybe if you're using WooCommerce, you can do something with that. You can really integrate almost anything with it. So if you're using WordPress, I would definitely check it out, have a look at it. Maybe it's handy for you for some reasons. So yeah, these were my seven favorite automation tools for 2022 that are going to help me in my online business. I hope maybe one or two of these tools are also going to help you. If you want, you can check them out and use my affiliate links that you can find in the description below.